The family of the late Sir James Mitchell say they have lost a pillar of the family. The former Vincentian Prime Minister, 90 years old, died at the Port Elizabeth Hospital, Beckway, on 23rd November 2021. Mitchell, who governed St. Vincent and the Grenadines from 1984 to 2000, fell ill on 31st October. He battled multiple medical conditions, including an enlarged prostate. Sir Mitchell's niece, Marina Mitchell Matthews, says the family is trying to stay in good spirits, and the memory of her uncle will continue to live on in the hearts and minds of all Vincentians.
Well, the family was expecting him to go. He has been ill for many, many months. We're hoping that the funeral can be done before Christmas, but there will be a lot of arrangements to be made. My most fond memory was being woken up at 4 o'clock in the morning in Beckway, and Uncle Sam taking all of the cousins, nephews, nieces on a very, very, very tiny boat to a little island, Petit Nevis, to watch the butchering of the whales at 5 o'clock in the morning. And that was a fantastic experience. Unforgettable.
Marina Mitchell Matthews also delved a bit into the early life of Sir James Mitchell and the events that led to him being the iconic figure that he is today.
It's a very interesting story. When my uncle was about 10 or 11 years old, his father died, and his mother was left penniless, because women didn't work in those days, and she had 4 children to raise. She subsequently got married to Alfred Baines, who raised those 4 children as his own. And I think I'm quite correct in saying that Mr. Baines, who was then the colonial treasurer, was the one who inspired my uncle to be more than a fisherman and more than a goatherd and become the Right Honourable Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
Mitchell Matthews says her uncle would be remembered for his contribution in fostering ties within the OECS.
It was great for the Caribbean to have that connection between St. Vincent and St. Lucia. My uncle was very close to John Compton, and that relationship helped build the OECS in its early days. And hopefully that foundation will stand and can go forward to even more closer unity between the islands going forward.
As for now, family and friends are busy making preparations to celebrate the life of Sir James Fitzalan Mitchell. For the DBS News World, I am Jason Darius.